Good evening, fellow Singaporeans and residents of East Coast GRC. Tonight, I want to talk to you about two things. First, is about your right to vote. And second, what you should expect from your leaders. Now, this general election, I'm very happy to note that 82 out of 87 seats are being contested. Now, that's amazing! Only our poor friends in Tanjung Pagar GRC are left out. All those friends who live from Cantonment Road all the way to Holland Village. Now, many of you have never voted before. Let me emphasize how precious the right to vote is. Every citizen has one vote. It is the one and maybe the only time when everybody has the same say, whether you are rich or poor, whether you're a student or a CEO. Therefore, it is very important that you have complete confidence in the voting process. When I visit residents, I often ask them whether they believe that their vote is secret. Many say they believe it. One couple even told me, "We don't care. Last time we voted for Workers' Party, we are still here, what?" So I tell them, "Last time we stood for election for Workers' Party, we are also still here." But for those of you who are less sure, let me say this. The Workers' Party is very certain that your vote is secret. We have been participating in every general election in Singapore since independence. We have examined the voting process very closely and carefully. There is no way for anyone to know how you have voted as an individual. On polling day, you will vote from 8 a.m. to 8 p.m. At 8 p.m., the ballot boxes are sealed in the presence of the candidate and agents from both the PAP and opposition. The boxes will then be transported under escort to the counting centres, so there's no risk of hijack. When the votes are counted, this will be done by civil servants from different departments, again in our presence. After counting, the votes and records are sealed and stored in the Supreme Court vault. After 6 months, all of us go back to the Supreme Court vault to escort the boxes to be burned in the incinerator in Tuas, together with all our other rubbish. Now, 5 years ago, I was there after the last general election with Mr. Lau and Yaw Shin Leong. We found the seals intact and our signatures were still intact. We are completely satisfied that there is voting secrecy in Singapore. Now, some of you may ask, how come the PAP or Workers' Party knows which areas supported them more or supported them less? The simple answer is that the votes are counted by polling district. Each polling district may have about 2,000 to 3,000 voters, roughly about 10 to 20 blocks. So, we will know for each polling district what was the percentage which supported Workers' Party, but we will not know how an individual block or an individual voter. So, the Bian Huan Lo. Ga ga tao ga lang dong zi piao. Yeah, coming to that, some of you may ask, what about the serial numbers? Other countries also have serial numbers. This is to ensure that every person votes only one time. But the main point for you is that after the votes are counted, the votes are sealed and remain sealed until they are destroyed at the incinerator. The votes are not traced. Now, remember that the PAP would not want to risk their international reputation for this. The people of Aukang and Potong Pasir have been voting opposition for more than 20 years. It is your right. So please, when polling day comes on May 7, go to the polling station and put a cross in the box for the Workers' Party. Now, the second point I want to talk to you about today is what you should expect from your government ministers. And one thing that troubles me very greatly is how high the ministers' salaries are. Now, the Workers' Party's position is that the ministers' salaries should not be pegged to the private sector like it is done now. Instead, we should benchmark the pay looking at the political office holders in other first world countries. If you look at countries of similar size elsewhere, Finland, Norway, Denmark, New Zealand, they are countries with healthy democracies and they are well run. All these countries pay political office holders just a fraction of what the PAP ministers pay themselves. We should benchmark against these countries. But the PAP doesn't agree with that. Their formula is to pay ministers 2/3 of the average of the top 48 earners in Singapore. Is that valid? Can we say that each and every minister in the cabinet now would have been a top earning banker, accountant, lawyer, engineer, or CEO? Isn't it possible that some of the ministers are now actually doing better in the cabinet than they will be doing in their previous careers? You know, when this topic of ministers' pay comes up, the PAP likes to justify it by telling us how well Dr. Ng Eng Hen and Minister Shanmugam would have been doing if they remained in the private sector. Why don't they talk about some other ministers? Now, Minister Mentor Lee Kuan Yew previously said that it is not feasible to have foreign talent in the political leadership because our political leaders must have passion, the commitment, and share the same dreams as our people. I agree with that. Now, 4 years ago, ministers used to draw about $1.2 million annually. This figure has gone up, but let's use the old number. If we divide that by 12, it means that they are earning about $100,000 a month. Now, how does this compare with the average person? Based on 22 working days a month, ministers earn about $4,500 per day. Now, assuming they work 10 hours per day, they earn about $450 per hour. And that includes lunch hour. Now, the average person is only earning about $2,500 a month. This is something that the minister would earn in about 5 hours. Now, with such million-dollar salaries, how will the ministers share the same dreams as our people? The PAP government has often asked Singaporeans to make sacrifices during tough times. But if we are told that we can't get them to serve without paying top dollar, why should they expect more from the rest of us? The ministers are now asking stallholders to keep their prices down. But are the PAP ministers keeping their own prices down? Now, over the years, the Workers' Party has told the PAP in Parliament that their ministers' salaries are too high and why it is bad for Singapore. We intend to continue to pressure the PAP on this and other issues close to your heart. Now, for this, we need you to support the Workers' Party in East Coast GRC and all our candidates. So vote for the Workers' Party towards a First World Parliament.